Step into the mind of a cutthroat. If the streets cold weather all alone, blackness, gray hair, just snow. Villains don't be followed by crows. Call this the
So, hello and welcome to my second intro tutorial. Today I want to show you how you can cut your song and add it into Cinema 4D, and yeah. First, I want to say that, yeah, the last intro tutorial was a month ago, but yeah, I'm trying to be more active with this intro tutorial series. So yeah, just go into After Effects. I have After Effects CC 2014, so maybe it's different for you, depends on your version. And yeah, just go onto composition, make a new composition, name it something like music, and then put everything like I do, and then you can choose the frame rate. I would recommend 30 or 60. I normally use 30, I don't know why. I mostly make my intros like 12 seconds long, so yeah, if I want 12 seconds long, I need 360 frames, and then just press OK. If you wanna change this thing here, the display start, just control and click on it. Maybe you have this where you have the seconds. I prefer the frame thing here because it helps later on. Then you go into your folder, drag the music in. I have chosen Eminem, The Real Slim Shady, the Fisher remix, I don't know, yeah. Just drag it in onto your composition, open it up by clicking on this thing here, the triangle, click on the waveform, and yeah, just search the drop. Yeah, your preview should look like this. I checked from current time and everything should be alright. The frame rate should be the same as in your composition. Then just search for the drop. So I found the drop, it's around here. So like something around here, I don't know. And then click on your music layer and right click keyframe assistant, convert audio to keyframes, open it all up, delete the left and the right channel and click on both channels, click on the slider and go to the drop. It was something around here, and then click on this graph editor. Now you can see like a better view of the waveform, and I would say the drop is something around here, and I know that it is something around here because I heard it. Then I think probably it's this thing here because it goes up, so I think that's the keyframe. So then you can delete the audio amplitude again, and then click on your music layer, and then press on your numpad the star mark, or I don't know how to call it. For me it's above the 9th, I don't know where your star mark is, but it's on the numpad. Maybe you have to look up in the internet how to make a marker in After Effects, and then press it. Then you made the marker here on your music layer, and then you can like change it. I mostly put the real drop on frame 80, I don't know why I mostly do it like this. And yeah, you can again, if you like change where your real drop is, you can now go to, I don't know, frame 50 or frame 30, I don't know, I go just to frame 50 and click on the stopwatch on the audio levels and go to the beginning of the composition and drag it all down. For me it's at minus 48, and yeah, then I search for the last drop, something like this, and for that I right click keyframe, convert audio to keyframes, then delete left and right channel, open both channels, slider, and yeah, you search for the last drop. I just search it. Yeah, I think here I wanna end this song, something around here, I don't know. Yeah, I think it's here, so because I can see it's going a little bit up again. So yeah, and then you can go out of this graph editor, then you click on your music layer, and I normally put this on 6, go something like 3 frames forward, click on this option 3 times, 1, 2, 3, and put this again on 0, go to the end of the composition and drag it all down to minus 48, and then we can hear the ending. So it's going a little bit like strong on the music, I'm not sure how to call it, it's a little bit louder and then it fades out. And yeah, you normally have your song ready, you can like hear in it. Yeah, I think it sounds pretty nice. You can also add audio effects, something like better fade in or fade out effects. I have some, but I don't wanna like explain it in this video because it takes very much time. Then we can go to slider, click on the graph editor, and then go to the first drop and press again the star mark. So you have one mark here. And then I would say to every drop you would like to sync to, you should make a marker. And yeah, I'm just doing it, I'm just searching for the drops. Yeah, you can like preview it, and if you think you hear the drop, you can press the star mark and just let it go through. So I will make it. So yeah, that's not right. So yeah, that's my keyframes, and now you should try to make it more zoomed. I would say more, yeah. Just go to the slider, press the graph editor, and go around the first drop you made. And yeah, it looks like it's here, then mostly you are delayed, so mostly the real drop is before the marker you set. So just drag the marker here. Again on every marker, I think that's again the drop, and for every marker you do it. You can see it when it's going up. If you don't see it, you just have to try to listen to, just play it. You can choose the frame rate, you can lower it down so it's more slower. You can see the exact drop more precisely, so yeah, go to the next drop again. I think it's here. This song is very easy, I would say. Yeah, if you nothing showed up, you just didn't select the slider, so just click on the slider. I pressed it here, but I'm not sure, it's a bit different to see which one it is, so yeah, I'm just lowering the frame rate and just here in it while watching at this graph. I just like previewed it and always pressed on the star mark, and yep, it's more precisely yeah, it's something around here. So I think the last thing, maybe in the last drop, I'm not sure, never mind if it's not always correct, but it should be fine. Then you go to the next again. Yeah, here it's very obvious, it's probably this drop. Drag it again here, and then go to the last drop. Yeah, again I would say it's here. Check it here, the last drop I made was also on point. Yeah, that's our keyframes. So now you can open Cinema 4D with your text that we made in the first tutorial, and there you have it. And now how to add the song to Cinema 4D. First you go to Minecraft Effector and then choose sound. First you have also to go to composition, After Effects, pre-render, and then choose wherever you wanna like save it. I will save it in my folder here, right here. Then press on the output module, I don't know, and change the format from AVE to WAV. So yeah, it's an audio file that is used to put songs into Cinema 4D. So press OK, and then press render. Yeah, it's pretty fast. It shouldn't take very long. So then you go to your screen in Cinema 4D again, and then go to in your sound to soundtrack, load sound, and yeah, choose the music file you just created. It's called music.thing for me. Yeah, and then you have it. And change the frame rate here to the composition length from After Effects, so 360, and drag it all in so you can see everything, and then just play enter. Yeah, you can hear that the music is in Cinema 4D. And now I would like to have this markers here in Cinema 4D too. So go to Cinema 4D, click on layout, and then animate. So you have here a timeline. Just go to the first drop. I know it's around 80 because I always set my first drop to 80, and click create marker at current frame. Then click it. And then you go to the second one, you can switch between your applications. It's for me at 115, and you just scroll through. 115 is here. click again on this thing here and repeat this process for every like marker. It takes some time, but it will help. So I will speed it up at this time. So now I made like every marker. You can now close After Effects. I will just save it here. So I have a project file of my music file, and then you can go to Cinema 4D again, click on layout, and then startup or standard. I'm not sure which one, because startup is the same as standard for me, so we'll just use standard. So now you have your like music in Cinema 4D, plus you have these markers. You can see it, there are white lines when the drop begins, and yeah, you can hear the music, everything else is okay, and yeah, that was it for the tutorial. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed, please leave a like. If you have any question, feel free to ask in the comment section. I will answer every question you have, probably. And yeah, see you in the next tutorial. See you soon and have a good time.